Talking yesterday at the Citizen Summit, that in worship a lot of times we raise our hands and we're sacrificing to Him. And this next song says, I give myself away to you for you to use me. So what we're doing, we're laying ourselves out, we're pouring ourselves out for Him to use us. Opening up our arms, saying, Lord, in 2012, if in 2011 I didn't let you use me, in 2012 I'm gonna let you use me. I'm gonna give myself away, my dreams, my plans, my purpose for your purpose, for your dreams, for your plans, for your vision, Lord. We give ourselves to you. We give ourselves to you, Lord. That our yesterday wouldn't be like our tomorrow, Father. New levels, new visions, new dreams, new things. That you would awaken us in 2012, Father. Yes, yes, yes. I give myself away. I give myself away. So you can use me. I give myself away. My life is not my own. I give myself away. So you can use me. I give myself, I give myself away. Oh, we give ourselves to you. I give myself away, so you, so you can use me. I give myself away. My life is not my own.
I give myself away.
Oh, I want you to use me.
So you can use me.
To something great. The first thing the enemy wants to do is to release people in your life to say they see or hear something different than what God speaks to you. Are you following what I'm saying? That's why the next verse in Matthew chapter 7, verse number 15 says, beware of false prophets which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves. Couple of things I want to point out here. When it says inwardly, that word inwardly sometimes can be subconsciously. Oh, oh, they can be out to get you and not even know it. Oh, see, they can love you and still subconsciously be out to get you. It says inwardly, they are ravening wolves. See, when we read this and we say, it says, beware of false prophets. We instantly in our natural minds begin to think about the false prophet as somebody who's standing in a pulpit with a microphone and prophesying to something that doesn't come to pass. And then later on we say, oh, he or she must have been a false prophet because they said something that didn't come to pass in my life. But you have to understand that a false prophet is any voice that counts, curtails, or circumvents the accurate prophetic voice that God has assigned to your life. If you read your Bible, you will find that throughout Scripture, every individual, there were prophets that God raised up, and God assigned certain prophets to certain people's lives. Every king had a prophet assigned to his or her life. That's why Scripture says that He has called us to be kings and priests. Each one of you has a kingly anointing on your life. So if there's a kingly anointing on your life and in your life, then the pattern in Scripture is that every king has assigned to him or her a prophetic voice. And we have got to tap into the Spirit of God to say, Lord, who have you assigned to me? And any other voice, a stranger will not follow. Do you hear what I'm saying? I refuse to follow the strange voice in my life. I'll only follow the voice that is assigned to me, because it is only when I follow the voice that is assigned to me that the king in me begins to come out. My prophetic voice provokes the king in me. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying to you? Any voice that counters, curtails, or circumvents the prophetic voice that God has assigned in your life. So when you hear the word of the Lord say to you that 2012 is going to be the best year of your life, I receive that prophetic word. Now, in anybody else who has anything to say otherwise is now become a false prophet to me. Oh my God, do you hear what I'm saying? Any other voice that speaks to you and tells you you will always be in the place where you are right now has become a false prophet to you. Any other voice that tells you you will never be what God called you to be because you've made too many mistakes, that has become the false prophetic voice in your life. Do you hear what I'm saying? Anything that counters, curtails, or seeks to circumvent consciously or subconsciously, inwardly, ravening wolves. Do you hear what I'm saying? Now, this is what I heard the Lord say in worship. The scripture says, enter ye in at the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leads to destruction. And many there be which go in thereat. Because straight is the gate and narrow is the way that leads to life. The life that God has called you to is big. The life that God has called you to has nothing broken in it. Nothing missing. Jesus said, I come that you might have life. Zoe, the God kind of life, that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. Abundant is big. The life that God has called you to is a big life. The life that God called you to does not even realize or understand what it means to live from paycheck to paycheck.
That's right. That's right.
Are y'all still here? Amen. The life that God has called you to is a life where nothing is broken and nothing is missing, where your relationships are intact.
Amen.
Where you're not fussing and arguing and bickering and complaining every day, all day long. The life that God has called you to is a life. I'm not saying that challenges don't come, but the life that God is calling us to is a life that is so founded and so rooted in Him that when challenges come, we're able to see the challenge through our prophetic eyes and it doesn't bother us anymore. It doesn't throw us off track. See, anytime prophetically, whenever a challenge comes, the prophetic announcement is that God is getting ready to elevate you to somewhere else. That's the only reason He allows challenges to come, because He's increasing your capacity so that you can hold more. He is stretching you. Anything that is stretched is uncomfortable for a season until it gets used to being stretched. It's just like buying some socks, brand new pair of socks, and you stretch them and you pull them off, and they go back in place, and you pull them on and you put them on and they go back in place. But after several times of being stretched, then they begin to hold their new form. I wish I had help in here. That's the way it is in our life. If God is allowing a challenge to come, it's because He's stretching us. And sooner or later, we will become comfortable with where He has stretched us to. And then He says, all right, you got it. That's more capacity. Now I can elevate you and bring you to another place in your life. Somebody said, the life that God has called me to is a real big life. Now, watch this. Watch.